Now, I'll be talking about the role of early repair after a biliary injury. And I have a confession to make that I am a proponent of a delayed repair. Over the last so many years, with my very limited experience, we have seen good results with delayed repairs. And so when I was told to talk about early repair, I went into the literature. And as Rajvilas pointed out, that timing of repair is the most important factor. Let's see if it really is the case. So now when we come to the definition of, you know, the timing of repair, the terminology is quite variable. There are no standard guidelines per se. Immediate repair is, of course, intraoperatively done. Early repair is, there are two schools of thought. Some people say that it is within 48 to 72 hours. Some people say that it is within 7 days. And some people say that, which is the majority, that early repair constitutes within 2 weeks of injury. Intermediate repair is within 2 to 6 weeks, or in some cases 2 to 12 weeks. And delayed repair is usually after 6 to 12 weeks. And it is done up to 6 to 9 months after the injury. So this is one thing, that there is no standardization of terminology as to what constitutes early repair, what constitutes intermediate repair. Then we go to the type of injury. We all talk of, you know, when to repair, but nobody talks about what to repair. So with a biliary injury, you have a leak, you can have a clip CBD, or you can have a clip sectoral duct. And all these three types of injuries will present differently. So these are various kinds of presentations, early as well as delayed, that will be seen with these different types of injuries. And the most common factor in all of these is whether you can have immediate problems like bilioma, peritonitis, jaundice, cholangitis, or you can have delayed problems like biliary strictures and recurrent abscesses, lobar atrophy, portal hypertension. But the common factor in both of these is that the patient goes into a catabolic state, is nutritionally compromised, there is hepatic dysfunction either because of cholangitis or because of sepsis or because of cholestasis. And of course, there is coagulopathy. So these are compromised patients, and to investigate them, to treat them, really becomes a challenge. So this is the original algorithm proposed by Strasburg, where the postoperative diagnosis within 6 weeks, that we call the early repair. So he proposed that these patients should only be treated by percutaneous or ERCP drainage and a delayed secondary repair. But as Rahul sir said, that we began with laparoscopic cholecystectomy, and we initially had a lot of biliary injuries. And now as the learning curve has improved, the incidence of biliary injuries have probably gone down. So it is with biliary injury repairs also. But as we have gained more and more experience, as we have gained more and more insight into what goes wrong after biliary injury, probably the approach towards secondary repair might also change. So what are the arguments against early repair? And then these are the arguments that I have myself made to patients a lot of times. So there is an ongoing inflammation. You have injured the bile duct, there's a biliary collection, there's biliary leak. So there's an ongoing inflammatory process throughout the body. The vascularity may or may not be compromised. You don't know the total extent of injury because it might be a thermal-based injury. The patient may have sepsis and its related liver dysfunction. And finally, of course, these patients will be nutritionally depleted because of loss of bile and its fatty acids. So when we come to all the results as a consequence of all these factors, there are a few confounding factors that are hidden behind all the numbers that are seen with the poor outcomes that are seen. So outcomes of repair by specialized HPB surgeons, and this is nothing to do with degrees. It is better to have a good amount of experience rather than have a useless degree. So an outcome of repair by a specialized HPB surgeon is better than that by a general surgeon. That is because general surgeons have a high likelihood of having an end-to-end anastomosis, have a choredochocoredochal anastomosis, which is traditionally associated with a higher stricture rate. HPB surgeons, on account of their experience, usually tend to go for hepaticojejunostomy that has a higher success rate. General surgeons, this was a study by Stewart and Way, who are proponents of the Stewart-Way classification. So in their study, only 36% of patients operated by general surgeons had an adequate drainage of bilioma before attempting a repair. So an inadequate drainage has always been a predictor of poor prognosis, and less than 50% of them had assessment of vascularity by dedicated imaging prior to going for a repair. So it is rushing into an unknown territory where you have not drained the collections, you have not assessed the vascularity, and you are just doing a repair early on to probably to satisfy whatever the patient requirement is. And lastly, there is a delayed referral to centers with expertise. There is a tendency to hold on to the patient to try and treat it yourself. And it has been seen that even if an experienced HPB surgeon performs a delayed repair, the results are poor if the referral has been more than 7 days later. So the early management of the biliary injury is what dictates the long-term prognosis of the repair, whether the repair is early or whether the repair is delayed. So like we have learned with laparoscopy, similarly, we are going to now learn with management of bile duct injury, that inadequate understanding and a knee-jerk management of the pathophysiological changes will always lead to poorer outcomes. So it is probably wrong to blame it on the early repair rather than understanding the physiology that what you did was inadequate workup and inadequate treatment and not the timing of surgery. So this was a 2020 meta-analysis on close to 2,500 patients and some good authors in this. So it showed that there is no significant difference in morbidity if you repair early versus with delayed repair. There is no significant difference in the stricture rate also. And there is no significant association between timing of repair and mortality of the patient. So this is the latest study that has come out in 2020. Another study that was way back in 2014 assessed the results of biliary reconstruction by specialized hepatobiliary surgeons. And as you can see, early versus late repairs, the difference is not significant in any of the parameters, whether you take the immediate postoperative period or the long-term postoperative complications and the mortality. There is no significant difference with early as well as late repair. Like I said, the Stewart and Way, who are authors of the Stewart-Way classification, they have categorically studied this, that the timing of surgical repair does not influence the success rate. And this is a multivariate analysis where a biliary surgeon doing repair will have a success rate that is pretty constant over the spectrum of repair, whether you repair in the first week or after 6 weeks. And contrasting to that, a primary surgeon who has probably caused the injury, who is operating in a compromised setting, who is probably not that well trained, him causing an injury and then trying to repair it has singularly poor outcomes even after 6 weeks. So the expertise of the surgeon plays a bigger role as compared to the timing of repair. This is another very good article that has come out just now, where they have studied the timing of surgery in Strasbourg B to Strasbourg E injuries. And like I said, it is only the 2 to 4 weeks where probably the inflammation is quite high, which has poorer outcomes. Apart from that, within 2 weeks, after 6 weeks, after 24 weeks, the outcomes of surgery are not that different. So when you do the surgery is not that important. But again, like I said, it is the quality of surgery that is important. So to summarize, there is at present inadequate evidence that this has poorer outcomes. I mean, yes, we have seen that data in the past, but when you have a multivariate analysis where you remove all the confounding factors, probably the mounting evidence is showing that timing of repair is less important than the expertise of surgeon and management of the early postoperative period. So it might be better to refer these patients early to a specialized HPB unit, preferably within the first 2 to 3 days before all the systemic signs of sepsis are seen. And at these centers, these patients need to undergo aggressive stabilization, thorough evaluation, and evaluation for an early repair. Because as Dr. Rahul rightly said, a delayed repair means that these patients will have percutaneous catheters, percutaneous drains, PTBDs in place. They will be carrying these tubes. They'll be risking sepsis through these tubes, and that spends a lot of time, resources, and adds to the morbidity of these patients. So if you have the expertise, if you're at a good center that can offer these patients early repair, you can save these patients from all of these complications. So what to do when you are thinking of an early repair? The first and most important thing is you have to think of an early referral. You cannot sit on a patient for 7 days and then refer and then ask the surgeon to do an early repair. You have to drain all the collections completely, whether percutaneous or you put in a laparoscope again and drain the collections, but you keep the abdomen dry. You divert the bile in the form of PTBD if the patient is jaundiced or has cholangitis. Control the sepsis, broad spectrum antibiotics must be instituted, and a CT angiography and an MRCP, both must be done to ascertain the level of block and the status of the vasculature. Now, when do you do an early repair? So if the patient is hemodynamically stable, there are no signs of sepsis, if all collections are well drained, if there is no vascular injury associated, and if you or your team has an experienced HPV surgeon available, by all means, these patients will do well with an early repair. You should defer if a patient is hemodynamically unstable or has sepsis, or if there is associated vascular injury, or if the team does not have an experienced hepatobiliary surgeon. And lastly, how to do? Dr. Waghle has adequately explained to us how to go about a hepatic vaginostomy, but few points need to be highlighted that even after all the evaluation and imaging, it is the intraoperative assessment of the liver, the remnant biliary tree, and the vasculature that will decide whether you can go ahead with the repair or not. You have to identify the proximal biliary stump and take care that you don't dissect too much around it to damage the vascular channels that are growing around there. You have to adequately lower the hilar plate. Of course, you have to do a Roux-en-Y hepatic vaginostomy, preferably going on to the left hepatic duct because that's a virgin area. Like sir said, it will have good vascularity. It will give you good results. And a wide degenerative anastomosis that drains all segments. You should not leave any undrained duct. If you are having an early repair, having an undrained duct is harakiri. So that's the extent of my talk. Thank you. And like I said, I was a proponent of delayed repair. With all the literature that I have seen for this talk, I think early repair sounds a good enough option if done by a good hepatobiliary team. Thank you.
And thank you, EduSurge, for giving me this opportunity and share with you some of the experiences that we've had over the last two decades. It started with Prasad Waghle, and I think I'm honored to be, you know, on this program talking about a debate on early versus delayed surgery in bile duct injury. If you look at the timing of repair, and Prasad told us that it's stratified as early and delayed, but there's also a point to understand that it can be immediate, on table, or intermediate, 8 days until 6 weeks. But does this timing really translate into safety and efficacy? Well, the answer is no. Timing alone is not important. Next. If you look at the success of biliary reconstruction, it depends on a complete eradication of abdominal infection. That is the key. A complete cholangiographic anatomy demonstration, use of correct surgical technique as alluded to by Prasad Waghle, and repair by an experienced biliary surgeon or a repair by an experienced biliary group of surgeons like Prasad Pandey, Prasad Waghle, and Gunjan Desai. If the objectives are achieved, repair can be performed at any point with expectation of an excellent outcome. There's no reason to delay repair for an arbitrary period. Having said that, the debate is about early versus delayed repair, and I'll be talking more in favor of the delayed repair. The predictors of favorable outcome would be an early recognition of injury, early referral, no previous attempt at repair, and the involvement of a group of hepatobiliary surgeons. And these are more relevant variables than the timing of repair. So Gunjan, you can say that it was in EduSurge, it was said that the timing of surgery may be very well in place, but there's a lot to be said for early referral, surgical expertise, sepsis control, and freedom from failed repair, failed attempt. When one looks at the early repair, a successful immediate repair can result in minimum morbidity, short hospital stay, and low hospitalization costs. And that is what every patient wants. Nevertheless, it will be possible only in cases with a ligated or clipped duct without bile leak and without biliary sepsis or without sepsis of any form. If repair is done as high as possible in the hepatic hilum, a safe anastomosis can be done in a healthy non-ischemic duct. This was alluded to earlier. But the repair can be performed within 2 weeks only in the presence of a clean surgical field. So early repair looks promising, but the scope is indeed limited. Next. As opposed to that, the basis for delayed repair is that most patients with bile duct injuries present with a bile leak and sepsis. Thus, early repair is not recommended. Percutaneous drainage of the bile with an expert person like Rahul Sheth and endoscopic stenting are the mainstay of bile leak because they convert an acute bile duct injury into a controlled external biliary fistula. The ensuing biliary stricture should be repaired by a biliary surgeon after delay of 4 to 6 weeks once the external biliary fistula has closed, which means that you drain now but fix later. You do as much as necessary in the beginning and as little as possible, but delay it and then fix it later. And these are some of the examples where you have a stricture with a fistula and Rahul has put in a PTBD and helped us control the leak. These are clips. Now you have two separate ducts. This is a stent in situ with a stent placed with a bile leak. So the principle is drain now and fix later. Next. The basis for delayed repair is that the tissue is inflamed, edematous, vascular and friable. And sutures of an early repair are likely to cut through with high risk of anastomotic leak, which is one of the most important factors for anastomotic stricture. And more importantly, an associated vascular injury, which occurs in a significant number of lap coli associated bile duct injuries, is also a contraindication for early repair. And as you can see in the pictures below, you have the aneurysm developing from the hepatic artery that is following a badly done laparoscopic cholecystectomy. Next. The objective of the debate then is to determine the optimal timing for repair of bile duct injury. Is it early or is it delayed? The heterogeneity exists in the literature regarding the optimal timing of surgical repair. And it remains unclear to what extent timing determines postoperative morbidity and long-term anastomotic function. And timing is stratified, as we discussed earlier, into four groups. Let's go to the next slide, please. The review of literature clearly shows that a large French national survey, although biased by its retrospective nature, this is as early as 2013, indicated that the best timing to repair a bile duct injury is beyond 45 days. And the best results can be expected in the hands of an experienced hepatobiliary surgeon with bilirubin repair as the best form. Next. A review in HPB in 2015 said that immediate repair, there were 39% complication and 64% failure rate. As compared to that, with a late repair, 14% complication and 8% failure rate. A Danish review looked at the mortality, 4% mortality, 36% morbidity, 30% restricture rates, and only 46 demonstrated uneventful short-term and long-term outcomes following early repair. So the message is, bile duct injury repair earlier is not better. Next. With an algorithm of assessment and management of bile duct injury by a tertiary HPV center, equivalent outcomes can be realized for patients undergoing early and delayed repair of bile duct injury. Outcomes following the repair of bile duct injury are influenced by the center and the surgeon's experience. So this is the perspective that Prasad was talking about, that it doesn't matter whether it's early repair or late repair. What is important is that the experience of the center and the experience of the surgeon is more important. Next. The rate of failure, and this is a systematic review and meta-analysis published in the Annals of Surgery in March 2020. And this looked at the rate of repair failure. Higher for early versus delayed repair. Lower for early versus delayed referral, important. No difference for on-table versus post-cholecystectomy repair. So obviously evidence goes more in favor of a delayed repair. The rate of post-operative complications, early referral outperformed delayed referral. So if you refer the patient early, complications are going to be less. No significant differences between early and delayed repair or on table and post-cholecystic TB repair. So the post-operative complications, as Prasad alluded to, are more or less the same. Next. At the cutoff period of 6 weeks, early repair was associated with increased rates of repair failure, post-operative complications, and bilirubin stricture. And the conclusion was early referral and delayed repair appeared to confer favorable outcomes, beneficial in decreasing rates of repair failure, post-operative complication, bilirubin stricture, and this is based on the systematic review published in the Annals of Surgery. Next. The success of treatment, and I can see Prasad Wagle's name somewhere here, that the success of treatment would depend on an efficacious surgery with symptom-free, intervention-free period with normal serum bilirubin and alkaline phosphatase levels of 5 to 7 years after definitive procedure. And this is what you need to achieve as a surgeon, that you need to have a perfect repair with a hepaticojejunostomy, a follow-up HIDA scan done about 5 years later, showing a good function. And that is important, that the best team and the optimal timing would help a lot in giving a successful treatment. The failed attempts at repair of a bile duct injury may end up in a high biological price for the patient with initial benign disease. And that is why it is important to understand the messages given through this debate. Next. As far as immediate repair goes, and Prasad Pandey alluded to this, that it is recommended to be done only by HPB surgeons. Initial repair by the original laparoscopic surgeon would be successful in as less as 17% of patients. But the first repair carried by a tertiary biliary surgeon was successful would be 94%. The repeat attempts at repair by the same surgeon is never successful. And 2/3 of patients with reconstruction in the primary center require repeat intervention at the referral center. So even if you're looking at early repair, you have to remember these points. There was one case which Rahul showed about intermediate repair. And this generally is not recommended because intermediate repair would be associated with higher risk of post-operative complications when compared with early and late repair. It related to poor nutritional status, dense inflammation, and immunologic deficiency. And the recommendation would be adequate sepsis control and delayed repair of biliary injuries should be considered for patients presenting between 8 days and 6 weeks after injury to prevent complication. The problem is sometimes patients get impatient. Sometimes surgeons are too anxious to be completing the repair. And that's why there's a knee-jerk response. The take-home message, and it's very convenient because all of us are sitting at home, delayed surgery yields better results. With early surgery, it may be a case of compromised surgeon operating a compromised patient in a compromised setting. Equivalent outcomes only when managed by a tertiary HPB center. An extended injury into the bile duct, referral to a tertiary center after therapeutic interventions, and early repair are independent negative predictors of outcome. So therein lies a message, my friend, that a knee-jerk response, which is to rush and fix the leak, is not good. The wiser response is to be patient and fix later. Thank you very much.